My name is Joy Lou, and today I will be reading a fan fiction of SMG34, which is SMG4X SMG3. The reason why I'm whispering because it's at night, it's like at 11:36 p.m. as you can see, and I'm probably gonna make two parts of it. Hey, Cleo. Wait, if you don't know who Scalia is, it's my cat. She's very sweet. She just wants some attention. Hey, stop it! There you go. Alright then. We will be reading. It's by Fangirl. Snowdrift. Also, I like the ship SMG4X SMG3. And started to ship these two together. This is only my second ever written fanfiction, so it wouldn't be that great. I think it will be fantastic. As long as it's not like just like one paragraph over like something else, you know, some fanfiction that does that, and I think that's bullcrap. Anyway, what do you think would have happened if Mario had flunked out the two? Well, here's the alternate version of this, or at least in my way. Enjoy. If you hear meowing, that's for my cat. My cat is trying to communicate with the white cat outside. But first, where is it? So everything is the same in the video. If you watched it, I have. If you guys didn't watch it, you better go watch it now. Sorry about my cat meowing. If you can hear it meowing, it's pretty loud. But Mario ditches SMG4 and SMG3, so Mario goes home without them and eats spaghetti. Also, the penguin doesn't seem to come see them. And I'm thinking the pinkest parrot, like, well, making the pinkest parrot, like, very smart. And stuff. So yeah, next chapter will come up soon. I think this was published, well, making of it is 2016, maybe, I don't know. But anyway, it should be finished. I can't believe that fat Vidoid left us SMG4 on the side. So he's not saving us, SMG3 asked. SMG4 sighed again and said, nope. The two were stranded in the middle of nowhere with freezing temperatures, snowed in igloo, and had no food thanks to the pinkest bird. The worst thing is their only way of escape had ditched them to go eat spaghetti. That Mario, good old Mario, going out to spaghetti. The two boys were trapped. Of all the places you just had to run in here, SMG4 exclaimed. I agree, it would have been better being in the snow than here with you. SMG3 groaned. Be happy you're not dead. Said firmly, well, we're going to be dead soon, since that stupid bird. stay alive at least. As Ivor finished, suddenly a sharp pain ran through SMG3's head. The place where SMG4 had hit him while trying to get the refresher out of the Mingus bear hurt and bad. Yeah, that did happen in the video. Tears stung SMG3's face. Don't cry. It'll make you look weak, he thought. SMG4, of course, noticed. Hey, are you okay? He asked worriedly. Just PG. SMG3 snapped. Sorry about hitting you with that hammer. SMG4 said as he scratched the back of his head. Wait, you're apologizing? SMG3 said in wonder. Well, yeah. That was mean of me to do. So the most sensible thing was to apologize, even if we were. If we're enemies. SMG4 explained. SMG3 turned away. Hit his blush. The biggest bird smiled and nodded wisely. He then started to make choking sounds. SMG4 and SMG3 turned their attention to the bird and what it was doing. The biggest bird had caught up the refrigerator. Food! The two boys yelled in delight and grabbed plate of food from the refrigerator and chewed down on their food. Sorry, this was kind of short. At least it's not like 50 words. This is more like 100, actually. More than 50, thank goodness. Not making like any jokes, thank god. Anyway, let's move on to the next point. And cuddling. Okay. SMG4's stared at the certain plate in the fridge. SMG3 asked avoidingly. This is the reason.
Close.
Chapters in this. It's 12 and it's July 5th.